back in Minecraft 1.4. As you can see, the logo has been changed. It's updated quite nicely, and cute little creeper face over there. Otherwise, I'm just gonna play a bit of Minecraft and keep doing my place and just talk about some stuff. Let's see what happens. Okay, so if any of you are familiar with my setup, my castle, my keep, my mountain, whichever you wouldn't want to call it, you can see that this used to be the front of my house and it has been completely obliterated. It's because I was just thinking of a change, just going through some things that I'm like, I just need to change a bunch of stuff. And you can see, what is this wall? What are those bricks? What happened to the front of the house? Yeah, a lot has changed. I got really fed up with a lot of things, so, and now, I got yours back. Yeah, I know. He's so cute. Yeah, I got really fed up, and I was like, you know what, I'm gonna change everything. So, let's take a look at what I've done so far. Ooh, it's getting nighttime. Yeah, not too bad, there's dirt everywhere, but that's for, oh, that project up there, which I'm not gonna show you. But yeah, I figured today we're just going to work on this and have a chat about some stuff. Stuff that's been bugging me, some stuff that's on my mind, and also just updates and cool fun stuff. But you know what? I am going to find... Ah! A bed! Yeah, as you can see... Oh yeah. Let me show you some stuff while I'm here. Ah! Not the leather, no! So anyway... Yeah, this used to be my bedroom area with my fire pit that didn't work anymore. An obvious thing that you want to ask is, your fire pit's working again. Yes, you need netherrack. So you need to go into the portal of the nether, and you need to just get your shovel or your pick or whatever. It's easy to break down. It's pretty much every material that's in that place. And you need netherrack. Put netherrack together in a line on top of each other, whichever you want, and set it on fire, and it does not burn out. Hence, you can make your fire pit again. Yay, fire is good. And then, yeah, and I've changed a whole bunch of stuff. I've put a bunch of, made a bunch more storage places, and really just trying to get things, you know, that I'm experimenting with in order here. So I've got my my dyes and my bone meal and all that good stuff, you know, trying to figure that out. My flora, my fauna, what else? Yep, all my random other, this is like the random thing where it's, I don't even know what I put in here. I got all my music discs from getting creepers killed by skeletons' arrows. It's a lot easier than you think, just trust me. You have to go and hit the creeper at least twice with your sword, with your iron sword or whatever you want. And then just walk him around a skeleton for a little while. Trust me, it'll happen. And it drops every time, which is awesome. What's in this one? This is rough finished materials, wool, and well, I had all my stone, my finished stone that I had kilned, but I'm going to be using it for building, which is why I have it, and I have a rose for some reason. This is, yep. This is all just random components, gunpowder, so tough to get. Redstone, I had even more than that, if you can believe it. And coal, for some reason, the world I'm in right now has so much coal. I am very happy. And the nether provides me with other things. So yeah, I still haven't done this. You know, I've cleaned it out, basically extended it. Things aren't gonna be happening in here. I'm gonna keep going with it, but kinda got sidetracked. Not gonna lie, yeah, I got sidetracked and I saw the front of my house and I was like, it ugly. And so yeah, I wanted to build something nice and different. But like I said, I'm rambling now, so we are going to make a bed. Bloop. And we're gonna sleep till the morning. Hey, oh yeah, you can't get on the bed. Not on the bed. Bad dog. Oh, he's so happy. Yeah, so we're gonna work on this and we're gonna have a little chat about some stuff. Where did he go? Oh, there he is. Come on. That's right. You guard the front door. Guard it with your life. So yeah, just recently finished Fallout New Vegas. Fallout New Vegas. And I don't really know what to say about it. I put 106 or 108 hours into that game, and the ending was extremely subpar, and the programming, as we all know, just sucks. So there's so many glitches. I mean, I was at my friend's house and the game glitched. Probably the game froze. Okay, I haven't had a game freeze on my Xbox maybe once before. Okay, it froze 3 consecutive times at the end of the game. I was like, okay, I just want to finish this game so I can trade it in and never look at it again. And I'm a huge Fallout fan, okay? I started on Fallout 1 and 2, and Tactics, and, you know, and I was ready to embrace Fallout 3's new playstyle, you know? Thank you, Bethesda, for that. And I accepted it and loved it. But Fallout 3 New Vegas, for anybody who's a huge Fallout fan, you can probably skip it. The crafting system was awful, the housing system was awful, the inventory system, not on your actual character with your Pip-Boy, but in your housings that you can get in random areas of the world, terrible. Fallout 3 is so much better in every way, and I just, I don't even want to talk about it anymore. Moving on. Okay, let's, it's kind of tough to build stuff right now. Oh yeah, of course. Yeah, so anyway, so I did that, and the reason I finished that game and just got it out of the way was, one, traded in, because, you know, there's many, many, much better things coming out. Another thing, I started playing Divinity 2 for the Xbox 360. I was going to get it on PC, but decided to get it on 360 because I just finished playing everything on 360, so it just made more sense for the control schemes. It was basically a control scheme. I didn't feel like going back to keyboard and mouse just yet. So yeah, picked that up. Just so you guys know, Divinity 2 is a completely remastered version of itself. It's called the Knight Saga, the Dragon Knight Saga. Completely revamped graphics engine, tweaks to quest lines and all that good stuff. Yeah, so picked it up, been messing around with it. Very cool game. You know, along the lines of a basic RPG. Nothing, production value is not extremely high, but I mean, would you really expect it to be Mass Effect? Would you really expect it to be, you know, Dragon Age? No, it's not going to be that. It is still very, very addictive and very fun, and the voice acting is extremely, it's great. It's so character, it's ridiculous. In a good way, of course. And, yeah, I also want to just speak about that game because I ran into a bit of a problem. Some frustrations in it, just to give you guys a heads up. You will get a quest eventually when you first start. You'll probably be level 8 or 9 by the time you get it, you know, even before that. And it'll be to go to a bandit camp. Okay, now when you go to this bandit camp, just please make sure you have one of two or three things. First thing you need a bow. Or if you are a caster, you are okay. But I would still strongly suggest getting a bow. Two. You probably want to get as many mana potions, health potions as you can before you go, because the door does lock behind you. And that's pretty much that. You've got no other options. Once you're in, you're in. That's it. Hard way, hard way, hard way. Apart from frustrating puzzles that don't really explain themselves, you just kind of have to figure out through trial and error and death. Another thing you want to do is save your game a lot. The autosave feature is unfortunately not developed or practically not even there. It only saves when key story elements happen, autosavers, and yeah, it's not good enough. You will find yourself running into a lot of trouble. By a lot of trouble, I mean you will be like, oh, I did so much. Oh, look, I got killed by something stupid. Oh, now you did. Yeah, that's that just happened. So you definitely want to be very careful. The game is pretty unforgiving. But otherwise, very, very cool game. Oh yes, of course. Once you get to the bandit camp, you're gonna be facing a boss called Jagon. I just wanna call him Jagoff. Jagon, okay. Now, he's a son of a bitch, because he can shoot you once with his bow and kill you, or he can hit you twice with his sword and kill you. His specialty is his sword, yet he can kill you one shot with a bow. Go figure that. You definitely have to... I sat there for 2.5 hours trying to kill this guy. Okay, now, that's not through my lack of trying, and not through my lack of skill. He basically just one-shots you for everything you want to do him. So, I'm just going to give you guys a heads up again, just be careful, because it is a real pain in the ass doing that one. Like I said, definitely have a bow, and definitely bring some magic with you. And anything else along those lines, because it's just ridiculous. I'd rather kill him ranged than anything else. Anyway, 2.5 hours, and I must have died about, I don't even know how many times you can die in 2.5 hours. A lot. Wasn't very fun, starting to not have much fun with it, but I know it's just one of those frustrating things that happens in games that they overlook. And apparently the game wasn't that hard in its original concept, in the German version, or the Euro version, or however you want to say it. Yeah, so apparently our version is a lot harder. Yay for hardness, yay for difficulty. But yeah, anyways, so that's that. And there's something else I want to talk about. Oh yeah. So I went to go see Your Highness on the weekend with some friends. And if you don't know what Your Highness is, it is a movie with McBride and... Anyway, look, it's a fantasy movie, and it's basically a play, like a play on things such as Pineapple Express and stuff. It's not meant to be taken completely seriously. It's a spoof of, you know, fantasy movies and like that kind of thing, but with you know, potty humor and swearing and, you know, bad accents for, you know, the exact reason why you would want to hear a bad accent, you know, just for fun. You know, everyone had a lot of fun with that movie, and you know, it had more magic in 2 minutes than Harry Potter has had in the entire series. So yeah, anyway, very, very funny movie. I strongly suggest you guys go see it. It is just hilarious. I know it's gonna be one of those all-time classics, such as like Princess Bride, Willow, you know. It's just something that it's just gonna be like, yes, this is just a fun movie, and it's gonna stand up to test of sometimes, whatever times those are. But yeah, go check it out. It got horrible reviews, and that's another thing. Reviewers need to learn to just be a little bit more chill with things. Not every movie is Oscar worthy, and not every movie was made for that exact reason. Some movies are made just for fun and for spoofs and for people who actually just want to get a good laugh. So go see Your Highness. It is great. It'll be probably one of the funniest movies you've seen all year. I know that that and Johannes and Hobo with a Shotgun is definitely my favorite movies of the year so far. Everything else can suck it, because everything else has sucked. And I go to movies quite regularly, so yeah. Anyways, what else do I want to say? That's about it. Well, anyways, I'm going to go now. And hopefully when you come back, you will see a nice new complete area of my house. Anyways, till then, have a good one.